Seti starts in a pretty interesting position. He's close to Daddy Dearest in case he wants to backstab him and just go straight for the pharaonic throne. He has a lot of sacred Egyptian soil close to him, a lot of Egyptians in general. He can go west even towards Libya. He can go towards the Sinai, and if he's crazy enough, to his beloved half-brother Amun-Mes in Nubia. And trust me, bro, I'm a mess too. But Seti dons the Mask of Set, and he becomes the Avenger, as you can see by his new drip here. And he's just gonna go on an all-out murder rampage. When I am Pharaoh, our lesson... While this might be an easy battle to auto-resolve, do I look like a little bitch to you? Of course not. We're gonna fight to the death because that's what Set demands. So, when it comes to historic facts about Obor Seti, we don't really know as much as we should. According to the Harris Papyrus, he was a pretty incompetent ruler, but that's only if you trust Ramses III's propaganda. What we do know is that Seti was embroiled in a civil war against his, totally half-brother Amun-Mes, and trust me bro, I'm a mess too, I would understand that if you want to fight for the throne and stuff like that, but... they would basically constantly destroy each other's monuments, rewrite them, etc., etc., until Seti would win the civil war. That's why we barely have any information on Amun-Mes, and a little bit more information on Seti. Here's another little gossip fact. Some older scholar theories actually even suggested that Seti's son, Sipta, was actually an illegitimate son of Amun-Mes, but that's up to you to decide if you believe pop culture that much or not. Anyway, Seti in the game has some interesting mechanics. Besides being a bloodthirsty brute, he gets expendable levy units with a lot of manpower. Seti doesn't care where the blood flows, as long as it flows, and well, as long as it's not his, I hope, but you get the point. Let's open with some counter skirmishing on the slingers. Let's start charging our clubmen in. Clubmen, fantastic units. Overall in Pharaoh, every weapon has its purpose, honestly, and that is one of the greatest things about the game, in my opinion. Now let's get the Royal Kapesh Guards to charge in. After all, you might start with levy units, but you're still the son of the Pharaoh, you're destined to get the crown, and look at the Kapesh Guard. Maximized and drip, with even divine symbols on their shields, you know they will butcher their enemy as soon as they connect. And speaking of connecting, it's about to hit, and just look at that. Too bad they don't have any precursors, but with a blood pack, this would be so brutal. When it comes to animations, it's finally back to matched combat so units can actually duel properly like in the older games and formation combat, though two-handed weapons, I gotta be honest, they kinda suck. And chariots are gonna need some work, but until that point, at least we still have time. So now we're gonna use Seti to flank here. These guys are getting crushed. Seti doesn't care that he's going after basic slingers, he's doing it with style. Cart of the Shardana bodyguards with, Setman himself in front here, with that weird-ass mask. I don't even know why CA thought that was a good thing, but I love that they did that. The slingers are just gonna get massacred. They can't stand against the rightful Pharaoh. Just look at him, look at all that edge, look at all that Kopesh edge. Okay, these guys have effectively been broken. There is nothing more to do. We're just gonna flank with the Royal Kopesh Guard and the Clubmen. Let's take a look at a little bit of levies. Rock clubs, or better said, stone clubs, were massively phased out by the time of the late New Kingdom. Essentially, in a way, it's kind of a sci-fi weapon, let's be realistic here. Especially since the New Kingdom economy was so powerful, it could mass outfit even the lowliest soldier. But hey, it looks cool, and it has a gameplay purpose. Clubs completely ignore armor at the cost of doing no base damage. The Axemen are putting up a brave fight versus the Clubmen, but unfortunately, this feels like it's just their demise. Seti is a little bit too strong and a little bit too berserk. I think this is it for this battle. After such a glorious victory, of course, we have to pray to Set, our patron god, and then we're gonna move to recruit some units. Seti loves his expendable troops, and let's actually go for some axe conscripts, because axes are very flexible in this game. We've also gained a new item, incense, okay, and the weird case Seti ever decides to become a builder, I guess he puffs a little bit of the incense and we're all good. Also, breaking enemy armor faster for low tier troops, I think he'll be fine with that, and let's increase his presence because he truly is a sight to behold. We could wait for them to rally out, or we could just frontally assault because we're insane and playing Seti. Listen, Seti might be a little bit of a goofball, and I promise the voices are not taking over, so he's attacking a settlement frontally. It's totally not the voices or the magical point-and-click arrow in the sky directing his every move. We're fairly evenly matched. The enemy has a lot of good troops. We have a lot of levies and some good troops, but that's not gonna stop us in our quest for the Bronze Age world domination. As you can see, Seti and an elite crack squad of lore Egyptian axe conscripts. Yeah, I don't know why I turned them to be the crack squad. Are flanking while we have an assault by the lore Egyptian club militia. Yeah, you know, something is telling me this is not gonna work out as much as my wildest dreams have hoped, but you know what? Crazier things have happened in history, so we're just gonna get a clean countercharge on their general here. He doesn't even bother, he doesn't even seize us as a threat, but it is what it is. Mace to the face, you can't argue with that. Not at all. We're also gonna bring the Royal Kopesh Guards to give him a good day while we counter skirmish. We're getting the Axemen. That's perfect, so the lower Egyptian Axemen conscripts will massacre their counterparts. Meanwhile, maybe we can get Seti in around to flank. Get rid of the slingers, even though that's not his job, but Seti is unhinged in a good way, okay? Let's take a look at some of the Royal Kopesh Guards. They're just going in for the slaughter. Kopesh with a blood pack? This would just be unrivaled carnage. Why is there no blood pack yet? I do not even know. But the animations are fine though, and we finally have proper matched combat outside of two-handers sucking, but we don't have two-handers right now, do we? And that is fantastic. Okay, Seti manages to get some of them stuck here. We're gonna try to get them scared off. Perfect. The conscripts are getting demolished, and oh my god. Setman himself is just gonna butcher some slingers. Not much to see except them running in panic like the little pansies they are. But wait a moment. Swordsman conscripts? No way. You're not taking Seti's glory away. We gotta kill even higher value targets. The Shardana mercenaries are just mercilessly going in, kicking, flailing, and using their Kopesh to butcher the poor little native Egyptians. And you know what? If they do a good service, I guess they might even settle here, because that's kinda how it works. Okay, let's get ready to counter skirmish more. We're decisively breaking through the front. Their general cannot stand behind the Royal Kopesh guards. Seti did a great flank, but let's actually disengage and get the slingers away from our faces because we don't want rocks at the head. Okay, they're getting butchered. Doesn't matter that you got a stone club, bro. I got armor, I got a shield, and I got Kopeshes. What do you got? Well, you got a death sentence. See you in Duat, bitch. And this is just perfect. Well, as much as we're making that unit disengage, that is fantastic for us. Lower Egyptian swordsmen are also getting demolished. The enemy slingers, yeah, you can see the flags are tattered. There is just no way. Militia has also been decimated. However, their general is not exactly doing the best. But it's fine, our Royal Kopesh guards can make quick deal of him. Seti, are you okay? Yeah, Seti's getting no problems here. The blob is fine because it just butchered the conscripts. They didn't even get to kill that much. For me, that's a win-win, honestly. Okay, counter skirmish phase is done. These guys are shattered. We need to finish off the other guys so they don't shatter. Or actually, wait a moment. These guys have got their shield arm exposed a little bit, so let's get some fire in there. It's perfect, perfect. It's a little bit of chip damage. We don't need them to do too much damage. Look how much counter skirmishing. 63, 39. Let's move them here. Seti, you know what you gotta do, buddy. Come on, don't stop failing. Well, don't start failing. Okay, the mercenaries are just... Oh, yeah, they're just gonna butcher them. Blood pack, can you, like, come today? Thank you very much. Perfect. Okay, so a breakthrough has been made. The Axe Conscripts failed. Seti is just gonna finish demolishing what's left of these guys, and that is just amazing. Counter skirmishing is happening here, but they're not able to break through the front as easily. I don't want my slingers to get there, so I'm just gonna move. My units need to get disengaged. It's not gonna be much of a problem because they're all wavering here. They're basically as good as done. The madman Seti actually frontally attacks a settlement and gets away with it. Wouldn't you believe that? Well, actually, no, I do believe because I'm the commander. So now we managed to go for a breakthrough. We can get a decisive flank over there. The crack squad of Axemen is going to meet the lower Egyptian spear militia, and Seti is just going to go for a nice little flank. Isn't that just perfect? In general, the weapon variety is fantastic in Pharaoh. We just need to actually level up and unlock all the cool units. They managed to catch them here. This is fantastic. The slingers are going to get butchered. Absolutely butchered. Meanwhile, the rest of the army is coming. Seti with his Shardana mercenaries. On the front side, it is a slog. Listen. But thankfully, the royal Kopesh guards are going to make it through the day, and we get flankers coming in. You know what? I think this seals the fate of the city pretty decisively. Once again, Seti's maniacal genius wins the day. Let's go for a last charge. Look at him in his Setman outfit. Getting ready for the last rear charge. And with this fate, our province is secured. And there's nothing that can stop us from becoming Pharaoh. Unless, well, the entirety of Egypt unites against us. But that's something we would prefer not to think about. Once again, Seti proves that he is apparently imperishable. Let's see what we got here. Pretty good loot. And oh my god, just look at the kill score on Seti and the Royal Guard. This is actually brutal. Even the slingers. Everything has got crazy kills. You know what? We love the sound of that. And let's be benevolent for now. We don't want to, you know, exterminate our future subjects too hard. Oh my god, no, no. We just got the best retainer in the entire game. We just got the best retainer in the entire game. Everybody loves Egyptian beer. Isn't that right? Yeah, okay, that's actually bullshit, but let's pretend everybody loves Egyptian beer. And with this, Seti's initial conquest is over. Will he go for the Holy Land? Will he go for Nubia? Will he usurp Big Daddy Merneptah? Or maybe a trip into Canaan? That's something you're gonna have to find out and see in the next episode. And until the next time...